Everybody, it's Invicta. Let's have another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. We did have another video cross 3,000 likes or more, which now puts us at 64 out of 90 already on our way for the keyboard tracker episode. Thank you all very much. Hope your weekends have gone off to a fantastic start here on a Friday. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by 3D Dalek. Title of the thread was Giga Chad Team for a Really Bad Start, all in all caps. That part was emphasized because it was in all caps here. Yes, indeed. Friend Finder plus the Giga Chad. What can you say about it? It was a legendarily amazing carry job by that one. If you didn't see that episode, well, you probably should. I'm going to let the comments let you know which episode that one was. It is going to be Z-Dem Vizip. We've got great tiers thanks to Sad Onion. We also have what appears to be decent, actually good damage as well. Bad shot speed, but we also have Vade Retro, which of course allows us just to do that. Yeah, Vade Retro is not too bad. The Secret Room should be to the right of here. And we also have a library to start with. Now, obviously, I'd like to get into the library. Vade Retro, as much fun as it is to see it kind of just chain a whole bunch of different... As much fun as it is to just see it chain a whole bunch of kills just back-to-back like that, it isn't really practical, in my opinion, for the entire run. I mean, if you have nothing, and I mean nothing else better, then sure. Vade Retro is better than literally nothing, but other than that, yeah, give me something like a Book of Shadows, give me something that gives us a Soul Heart, or even something like the Book of Sin, and we got both of them in here, so Book of Sin, of course, is going to be very useful for us to get a Lover's Card. Okay, so Lover's Card, we can use this inside the Secret Room, and this could be a very, very interesting start if we get lucky enough. I am going to hold on to the Book of Shadows, because I do like to, I do value the shields a little bit more. I'm going to use the Lover's Card, and we get Inner Child, which, I mean, it would have been a lot better had we gotten, like, something else. But hey, Inner Child at least will give us a respawn. If you're wondering where the empty heart came from, that's from using the Reverse Lover's Card, which takes one of our heart containers away and then gives us, yeah, and then gives us an item based on that, current room's item pool. It's a very difficult thing to say. Montezuma's Revenge, of course, item that I absolutely love, especially if it's combined with the Book of Shadows. We'll get ourselves IV bag, which I'm not going to use right now. No, you cannot use the IV bag while you have the Book of Shadows activated. It will kill you. Don't ever, ever, ever make that mistake ever. Ever, okay? All right. We might be able to get to 15 cents, which would allow us to get a premium item inside the store, which we are not looking at right now, of course, but about to be in there soon. I didn't want false PhD because these stats right now are just too good to let go. And yes, we could get some more damage for like luck or something like that, but it's not really something that I'm overly interested in doing. I have a bomb. I was sitting there trying. I was like, why can't I place this bomb? Well, you can't because it's... Anyway, Montezuma's Revenge, of course, fantastic attack for us. Allows us to shoot at a brimstone-esque level of damage. And what's so nice about it is that Montezuma's Revenge actually does have synergies with other items too. So, yeah, this is what I like to do. Draw them in close, hit them with the Montezuma's Revenge. It is a little bit cumbersome to use right off the bat, but you will if you do learn how to use Montezuma's Revenge effectively, then you will be rewarded with a very, very powerful, and I mean very powerful, early game. Can we push this out, I wonder? I don't know if this will blow up on spikes. Does not. Okay. Anyway. By the way, we have the callus. That's the reason why we're able to walk over the spikes without us having to incur any sort of damage penalty. See if this big brain play is worth it. It wasn't. Well, I mean, we got 2 cents, so I guess whatever. But yeah, Montezuma's Revenge, fantastic hard carry item for sure. It allows us to just beam down everything in our path. And it is so much fun to play with. If you are able to get good with it, you'll be, again, rewarded with just an amazing amount of damage that you can rely upon, that you can, you know, control very, very, very well. It's very good early on against bosses. I mean, it's just good on every single level. I'm going to go back and get our Sun card. Yeah. So a very good start here for us. Look at that. We even get ourselves another penny here. So, yeah, I mean, fantastic. We have Spike Immunity. We've got actual immunity with the Book of Shadows. We have Bookworm, Montezuma's Revenge, An Extra Life, Sad Onion. I mean, what else could you want? All that in a bag of crisps, as the Brits would say. Secret room gonna be right here. Excuse me? There's the D-Infinity. I mean, we did have a good D-Infinity run the other day. Maybe not necessary to re-roll this, but we could definitely re-roll the Book of Shadows, and then I guess we're going Glitch Crown, everyone's favorite. I absolutely do not like Glitch Crown. It does give you a lot of options for sure, but it's just an annoying item to deal with. However, if you are good at retrieving the item that you want and your timing and all that kind of good stuff, it is very, very, very rewarding. Yeah, this would constitute an item room that I don't care about, but I'm going to go for Polydactyl here. Freezer Baby may have been better for that. It just kind of depends. I like having Polydactyl. It allows us to have two cards or two runes or anything like that, two consumables, essentially, which is nice, admittedly. Our battery. I do want to go for the mystery gift here. And the reason why I want to do this is because we have Glitch Crown. I'm going to use this inside of the secret room, and this is guaranteed to shuffle through more secret room items, even if we get Lump of Coal. And Lump of Coal ain't bad to get here either, so let's see what we can get here. Transcendence is... it's tempting. Tempting, tempting, tempting. And we're going to have to get a full charge on the D and Fizzle. We can do... Transcendence early on is nice, but God, just having that rotating, knowing that we have a reroll and having Glitch Crown, just having that rotating carousel of items inside the secret room is just, it's almost too good to pass up. Now, if we do take a Devil Deal here, we could go into the boss trap room as well and get another item out of that, which is certainly a course of action. Oh, well, unless there's no combat room. All right. Now we're going to have to take a Devil Deal in order to get into the boss trap room, or we go play the sacrifice room. I think that's a big waste, though. We can die in the Devil Deal and still be able to get in there because we have Inner Child, so that's fine. Now, this is a perfect example of a boss that gets absolutely dominated by Montezuma's Revenge. I'm actually going to go Stapler here for damage and not Blue Cap. Well, Blue Cap is HP as well. I'll go Blue Cap. I mean, it maxes out our tears rate, so that's fine. Either Pact or Guppy's Eye. Oh, man. Or Ouija Board, too. That's such a big decision here. I'm going to go for the pack. It gives us the tears up and damage up, more importantly. We needed a little bit of extra damage here, so I'm fine with that. Let's go all the way back to the secret room now and go reroll that pedestal. I'm not going to go for transcendence. Even though it is flying, it doesn't give us any other stats other than that. So, and I'm obviously fishing for death certificate or a rock bottom here. And we keep her sack for free, I guess. I'd be very careful not to misplace that one because obviously the next one was DM Trainer. Now, I am going to play this a little bit more aggressively because we've got ourselves the Glitch Crown. I still am going to go play for the boss trap room. Again, this is a little bit aggressive, but because we have the Inner Child, I don't mind doing this. I mean, I Yes. I guess magic scab? I think we've gotten not great rolls here with Glitch Crown. So now there are a couple more hearts on the ground here, so we might be able to still fully play this sacrifice room. It's gonna be close. The spikes, y'all need to figure out which side you want to go first, alright? Really should go get another heart before leaving this room here, but. And we do get a devil deal or an angel deal item, which started out as the Book of Revelations. Gonna take the Book of Revelations. I'm not going to use the charge yet, though, because we still want to see. There might still be enough HP on the ground to make this happen. And I believe we will not get an extra item pedestal if we do get the if we end up fighting Uriel. It's just going to drop. He's just going to drop the key piece and nothing else. The quest items are not affected by Glitch Crown, thankfully. So it's quite the extended play here, but I think it is worth our while to do this. We also have a bomb now for the Tinted Rock. Yeah, this is one of those long roundabout sort of strategies that, you know, it's not going to pay off too. Oh wow, there's a double Tinted Rock right there. I just now saw it. I think a second bomb would be very, very nice. I think there is a sack inside of the store. Maybe. Nope, just kidding. But we could still go play. We could go play the arcade for another bomb as well to get that double Tinted Rock. The reason why that's so significant is because it's either going to be small rock or a ton of soul hearts. There's that Tinted Rock I was talking about. There we go. And then what we're going to do now is just simply use the Book of Revelations and then tap it for hopefully the 7 soul hearts here from the sack room, which we did get. And Destik. Now we don't really care about the regular Tinted Rock there, and we do care about the double one because I still want to. I wouldn't mind, even though our movement speed would be actual doo-doo, getting more damage is always going to be nice. So we just need one bomb here. Could play this Demon Judgment too, which wouldn't be a bad play because of Glitch Crown. Come on, 3 Skull Monty, just one bomb payout's all I'm asking. Bro, just one, or give us heart so I can finish off this devil, this demon judgment. Okay, wow, this is a tough one here, but I'm gonna go for empty vessel. Then here, I think we just go for, I guess, Skatol. I mean, we could go for Lazarus's Rags. Actually, Evil Eye is not bad either. Go Evil Eye. Okie dokie. After a very, very, very long second floor, we're finally ready to move on. That was exhausting, but we did end up, I think, doing about as good as we could, minus those bombs that we got kind of cheated out of. We need to get rid of this red heart, though, so that's what we'll be looking to do next. And honestly, I didn't think that we were going to have enough HP to make that happen on that sack room. Okay, well, I guess we just phased through that bomb right there. Gonna take 9 lives, of course. Give us a little bit of extra backup there, and then we're only 2 Guppy items away from Guppy. Remember, we have Keeper Sack as well, so all the money that we could have spent on in the store, instead we spent on 3 Skull Monty, will give us stats eventually. A big Psyhorf right there. Now you're seeing the result of us taking blue cap, which really killed our shot speed, so we got to kind of push these tiers ahead. Unless we, of course, get Evil Eye, or we can just try to tough it out like this, but obviously, you know, with Psyhorfs and any Spoonbender shot, they can actually just do a full 360 on you and just hit you right in the face, which we don't really want to do. And using Montezuma's Revenge here for our primary source of damage is really, really nice. And speaking of really, really nice damage, we got ourselves Poly freaking Femus, which is going to kill our tears rate. But good God, the amount of damage that we're now doing with our tears and especially Montezuma's Revenge is going to be absolute bonkers. I mean, it's going to be, it's just, it's ridiculous, y'all. Like, I can't wait to show you how much damage we're about to do on bosses. And if you ever had a question about whether or not Montezuma's Revenge is not good or good, well, you're about to find out. We barely got away from that one. Now, why do we want to get rid of our red heart? It's because, well, quite frankly, we have the ability to fly, and we also want the damage shield from Empty Vessel. We cannot get the Empty Vessel shield until we actually get, well, rid of all of our red hearts. I do see myself some card reading. I do like. I don't know if we're going to be able to get enough, though. The half-price starter deck over there, too. Okay. Gertie Jr. was not able to do anything there. We need movement speed. Take the movement speed for the caffeine pill. We just need 2 more cents to buy card reading. Seeing there the pseudo-piercing shots. Ones I like to call pseudo-piercing. I say pseudo-piercing because they're not actually piercing shots, but they appear to be piercing shots whenever you shoot an enemy. With Polyphemus, if the amount of damage that you hit them with is enough to one-shot them, the rest of the damage is carried over, kind of like a Magic the Gathering trample effect in a way. And it will travel through to the next target. Somehow managed to still get hit because I, for whatever foolish reason, I'm still trying to use Montezuma's Revenge for our primary source of damage when we don't need to do that. And the act of us getting hit by a greed means that we lose a cent, so there we go. It's just too much. It's too much damage for me to resist from using. You know what I mean? Like, why kill an enemy that you're going to be able to kill anyway with a shot when you could just obliterate it with a beam of damage, you know? But do I need to do that? No. Should I do that? No. And I missed card reading. Good. A black market too. Wow. All right, well, there's Birthright, and there's also the glowing hourglass. Birthright is going to spawn three pedestals, which we are going to again have cycle through because we have a glitch crown. Get ourselves that. We got ourselves a dice shard over here too. Good lord, man. Pandora's box. I don't know what Pandora's box is. I think it's a boss item. We also have champion belt. Yeah, there's so many good options here. We could also roll to get... We could roll to get something else. There's black candle. There's soy milk. Wow, look at all this. Tech X as well. That's right, he willingly took soy milk. Who is this and what did you do with Sinvicta? That's why, because our damage is incredible with Polyphemus and soy milk. Get the compass, of course. We'll lose one of our lives. No problem at all. Use the dice shard to reroll. I do want Ares. And surprisingly, we don't want Sack Dagger, so I'm going to reroll this. And I will take Gimpy. We're just having a good old shopping spree. Now that right there was a great example of how Glitch Crown can really, really benefit you. I mean, we just got everything that we wanted there and more, really. And finder, we want Blood of the Martyr here for damage. Just because it is going to help out with the soy milk. It's going to help offset a little bit. The Polyphemus damage upgrade and the damage multiplier is going to help offset that soy milk downgrade that we get. As you see here now, we have just an insane amount of firepower. Our damage is only going to get better, especially with Glitch Crown, especially if we end up getting Guppy. I mean, the world is our oyster here. We're ready to take our big old spoonful. People eat oysters with spoons? Oh, no. I don't like oysters. Oysters are like, that's one of those foods that, like, even though I'm a huge seafood lover fan, never been down with the idea of eating oysters. It's not because I have any problems eating them or anything. It's just that, like, I legit think that, like, I don't want to eat like a bowl of snot. Oh yeah. We have to have money to buy stuff. Silly me. I don't know. What is it? Yeah, those of you who do like oysters out there, what is it about oysters that appeal to you? Is it the taste? Is it the texture? Is it the decadence of it? Like, what is it? Can I go for synth oil here? Ooh, man, it's a tough one, but we're gonna go for Twisted Pear. You actually get in here. Pentagram's also not bad. Burning through these 9 lives, but hey, you know what? That's what we got it for. Curse of Blind. Curse of Blind is an absolute no-go for Glitch Crown. As much of a Curse of the Blind phobe that I am for regular Curse of Blinds, it's even more extreme with Glitch Crown, because you absolutely have no clue what you're going to buy. Now, is it possible that we could lose this run even when I take a blind item? No, it's not gonna be possible. The only way that I'd say that would be even remotely possible is if we end up taking something like... it would have to be TM Trainer or Missing No. We've already seen TM Trainer. That being said, I'm still not going to do it. this is, again, Glitch Crown, you know, I poo-poo on it all the time, but, you know, I do like the fact that we don't have to worry about Glitch Crown screwing us over. Unless, of course, we take it too fast and end up getting little gish anyway, so. Not sure what these are, but we're going to take it anyway. I have a cult. Get Leviathan. Ghost Baby. Taking the two heart devil deals. And I have Blyle. Okay. Not really the greatest there, but it could have been good. That's the point. It could have been good. They might be saying, Victor, you just got done saying you weren't going to take blind items, and you just take a blind item, stupid. Oh, it's because it's a devil deal. There's no missing no inside of the devil deals. Thankfully. The good lord there ain't. Yeah, we are absolutely destroying things now. This pair helped us out, kind of multiplying our damage a little bit. And that is going to be Goat Head for us. Or Shade. I was almost for sure. I thought that we were for sure going to be able to land that, but jokes on me, I suppose. Just to save you all the... those of you... Sissy! How you doing, little sissy? I was going to say, just to save you all the hassle of having to listen to Tech X go all over the place and you blow out your eardrums with sissy! Little sissy, how you doing, sissy? We ain't going to pass up little sissy now, are we? No. It's not going to happen. Epiphor is not bad here for Tech X and Soy Milk, because that's going to increase our tears rate by a whole lot. Those are firing in the same, you see right there. Look how fast that ramps up. Yeah. Yeah, that's quite the big DPS boost. So why am I holding on to a High Priestess card? Get out of here. Get out of here. We don't even need the Callus anymore because we have Flying from Leviathan. Strangely enough, we almost made... We weren't that far behind from missing Boss Rush either. I'm feeling confident with this damage. I'm going to take the negative. No guppy item, unfortunately, so we're going to go ahead and reroll. There's Sack Altar. Do see a Maw of the Void, but we're not going to use Maw of the Void here. Not going to miss Goathead this time. And honestly, like, there's not enough over on that other pedestal for me to care about, so... Yeah, we still have two lives left. I'm really hoping that we didn't pass up a Guppy item on our Curse the Blind floor. We probably did. Because that's what's really going to take this run to the next level. We'll be getting Guppy. Our tears rate obviously is just redonkulous here with Epiphora now. We do have to be careful. We are on only one hit point, but we took the negative too, which might be a little bit bold of us, but I guess there's three things that could kill us. Missing No, TM Trainer, and then Hubris. Hubris could also kill us. I'm fairly confident that we're going to be okay. And we have Little Sissy, so ain't worried about it. Not sure why the Globin stood there. I thought for sure it was going to be moving. That one was my bad, Isaac. There goes Perfection, unfortunately. I think it's Bloat. Take Cat of Nine Tails for the damage. Damocles is up there. Guppy's Paw. One more for Guppy. There's Guppy's Tail. Alright, we got Guppy's Tail. Ebizzle isn't bad, but I'm gonna err on the side of caution. I think we'll be able to catch up in HP. That would be the throw of all throws. Going with nine lives and a super powerful, we can't lose at all, and then actually losing. Because I decided to go for Ebizzle. We want PJs here. PJs gives us a ton of soul hearts, and on top of that, we don't need any more tears ups. I actually put bloat in here. I know it might seem obnoxious that I'm just holding down the fire button, which is the reason why I turned it down, but you have to remember we have Epiphora, so I want to pre-charge that as much as we can allow us to just get a lot of burst damage as soon as we get into any room that we go into. Like, don't get mad at me. I didn't make the sound effects, all right? I just play the game. That file is good. Worry about curse rooms anymore, so we can freely go in here. It's a hearts, turns everything into hearts. Might be able to get some use out of that. Remember magnet. Now remember, we've got Guppy's tail now, so thus going down to zero keys, that's going to hurt us quite a bit moving forward, but at the same time, we're probably not going to need keys or too much else other than golden chests inside of the dark chest. Kind of weird how those bombs were attracted to our tiers there. I think they were getting pushed by the other Tech X tiers. There's an empty vessel finally showing up. We can play this a little bit. I'd be happy with two soul hearts. Or Sigil Baphomet. I don't want to shoot too high now for goals game. Okay, how about you start us off with just one soul heart? Okay. Now second one. Okay, now second one. No, come on. What is that? Wow. Okay. So we just got Epic Fetus from Glitch Crown. Wow, that almost makes me want to reroll. I'm not even going to lie. Man, that sucks. Curse the Unknown. Yeah, that epic fetus just literally killed this build. That really blows. I'm gonna be 100% honest with you. If it wasn't Curse the Unknown already, I would have already rerolled. I will probably still reroll. I'm going to take Toxic Shock, but as soon as I can see how much HP we have, I'm rerolling. Which is very dangerous with the amount of secret room items that we have. Because you can get Missing Node. But I'd honestly rather just play with that than, like, have to play with Epic Fetus. So, by the way, if you don't know what happened there, The fortune telling machine came up, it blew up and then gave us an item pedestal. And the thing about Glitch Crown that I really hate, same thing goes for Binge Eater, is that there's absolutely no frames at all where you can just pick up an item by, like, you can just run into an item pedestal and bounce off. There's no like layover effect. It's just instantaneous, like you get it. And that's what happened there, and it just so happened to give us Epic Fetus. Here's the maze. I wasn't even trying to pick that up, game. I take the halo, and then I am going to re-roll this as soon as we get a full charge. Yeah, at least we know where we're going. See what I mean? Like, we, like, I was just, there was zero downtime for me touching this chest and picking up an item. And that's the thing you have to be careful about when it comes to Glitch Crown and Binge Eater and stuff. Super bandage. We missed. What else do we have here? We got Brimstone. Oh, we have Brimstone Mark. Montezuma's Revenge. Along with, I believe that was, I have a cult. Which is going to be homing. But we also have Akeldama, which I'm not a massive fan of. Are things still alive in here? Is their damage that bad? 10.56 ain't bad. Remember, we don't have we do not have Glitch Crown anymore, so we don't have to worry about the item pedestals kind of doing that. Now that was a lot of damage there. I don't know what was going on in that other room. We get the rosary, which is gonna give us soul hearts and a tears up. Now that we can get any tears because we are currently tier capped thanks to Brimstone. We maintain Sissy, and honestly, that's the biggest thing. Okay, so we're going to D4. I'm not going to D100. Oh my goodness, what is this? We've got Monstro's Lung quad shot. Holy moly, look how many tears we're firing. What in the world? We do have Twisted Pear again. Blood Puppy. One Up. Soy Milk. Tech X. Eye of Belial. This is kind of like our original run, to be honest. That is a ton of... I've never seen that many Tech X shots before. Soy Milk, Monster's Lung, Tech X. And we have Binge Eater, too. Binge Eater. Whiskey November Quebec Whiskey Foxtrot Tango Zulu Alpha. It was a very powerful, strange run that turned into agony, which turned into somewhat agony. Oh yeah, Shade's doing that thing again. Victory laps. All you gotta do is exit out to the main menu, come back in. Gotta fix the animation there. Don't want to give everyone seizures. I think there are enemies somewhere. I'm gonna go Binge Eater. We could use some more damage here. We've got plenty of movement speed. I'd like to get one more Binge Eater item and then we can re-roll. At this point, it's just a re-roll fest at this point. There we go. Let's go find ourselves what it do in here. What it be in here? Fool card. Go ahead and take that. D4. Oh, we got 9 lives again. Chocolate Milk. We somehow maintain Guillotine. I have Belial. Okay. We still have the flat file too, which means that we can actually get these mimic chests here. We have I have Guppy. Worm Buddy. PJ is going to give us a ton of health. I mean, our damage ain't bad at all, really. What's the pair? We get, I think, Guppy again. Or are we already Guppy? We might already be Guppy. I'm not entirely sure what's going on anymore this run. You bet we're going to still re-roll just because. I mean, come on. Oh, we have Zodiac. That's where the Sagittarius is coming from. So we had Scorpio in the last one. I was trying to look for it in the item list and didn't see it, so. Oh, that was a lot of... I mean, that was a ton of projectiles that we were firing out. Oh, my goodness gracious. We got Strawman, Ipecac, Hamilacria, I think. No, we don't have Hamilacria. Yeah, we're doing 100 damage. Obviously, we don't want Straw Man because we don't want to accidentally give up a good item. Okay, we're back on Brimstone. Got Lost Soul Buddy. Check him out now. Oh, man. I think we have Tiny Planet Brimstone. Sausage. Yeah. Host Hat as well. All right, I can get down with this. Oh, we welcome back Binge Eater. Great to see you. Oh, no. What? Oh, God. That is Ipecac. Yeah, let's get rid of that right now. Holy. Okay. We have Lacrophagy, Revelation, 8-inch Nails, Deadeye. Oh, we have Host Hat. Or no, we have Pyro. Go get some. I'm just doing this for healing at this point. It's a Black Candle. Okay. Kind of digging this, digging the Lacrophagy Tech Zero angle. This is an anime arc I can get behind. Let's have the finger. Oh, we have epic fees again. Well, I think we know where we're going with this one here. Epic Fetus, Duality. Yeah. Let me know in the comments which reroll was your favorite so far. Definitely not this one for me. Yeah, marked Epic Fetus is not how I want to spend my Friday afternoon. Thank you very much. Perfectly fine without doing that. Nice block there by Infamy. Another Eternal Heart. Man, oh man, we are killing it on the HP. We also have Blood Oath, which I do not want. And I accidentally used the D8 instead of the D4. Good. So we are blessed with a little bit more Epic Fetus. Or possibly the entire floor. Do not, I repeat, we do not want to go to the next floor with this. Although I think we might have Pyro again. So maybe it doesn't matter. The reason why I say that is because we don't want Blood Oath to screw us over on our HP. Yeah, we do absolutely do not. Oh, we have Shard of Glass too. Okay. No, we don't. Oh, we have Ludovico. Oh, boy. Someone tell Bikini Body. Ludovico, Ipecac. Missing No. Oh, boy. And it gave us Epic Fetus again. So yeah, with rerolls, it's basically only a matter of time before you get Missing Node. Which I think is kind of lame. Because you can't get rid of it as soon as you get it. That was a lot of damage. But hey, at least if we do get it, the D Infinity will at least stop us from doing that. Oh no, Lost Soul Buddy. Oh no. Okay. Magneto triggered that chest before, like, I even was trying to walk over there. I think we also have IBS. Yeah, we have IBS, so another reason for us to get the hell out of this run as soon as possible. Excuse me. How are you still alive? Yeah, we have Maw of the Void. That's all I care about. We have Maw of the Void. Yeah, long legs, sure. I'm not going to reroll this because, again, we've got missing nose, so, like, we're going to get rerolled no matter what. Over cement, we'll go ahead and take. There's the Bible for, like, I think maybe the eighth time on this run. Hey, now we're talking. Got tech 2. Mom's knife almond milk. That's where that's coming from. And God's flesh as well. But we are guppy. We maintained IBS. Oof. I think that might be $3 bill. Yeah, it is. We somehow still have IBS. But at least, I mean, we can at least beat this floor with this build, and then the next floor we can reroll. Whatever missing no, if it gives us some garbage, we can reroll it. Obviously, the main source of damage here is not going to be Mom's Knife. It's going to be mainly Tech 2. This turned out to be a way more wackier run than I was expecting. Was not anticipating this to be a reroll fest, but here we are. Ape Goat doing its thing up there. I mean, at this point, what is it going to matter? We're just taking all the items. When the game asks us how many items do we want, we just said all of them. We just say yes, basically. Sure, why not? Fruit cake, why not? You know, why not? And we have 2 rerolls set to go for the next floor in case if we don't like what Missing No gives us. Put the Sun card here. Yeah, this turned out to be some kind of reroll monster that I wasn't prepared for. Oh my god, what is this? We got TM Trainer. It re-rolled us into TM Trainer. And we also have Wavy Cap now. So yeah, now we need to get out of this. We need to get out of this run immediately. And that's another reason why Missing Nose sucks. It's because it can give you TM Trainer. This is no longer a fun time. This is a we need to get out of this run before we die time. We need to get out of this run before the game crashes or before we die. And this is not the right way to go. This is thankfully a curse of the XL. I don't know where that fire is coming from, but it's not coming from me. Game Trainer loves to teleport you just randomly. I don't know where these bombs are coming from. In fact, you should probably just turn this video off now. If you don't like Wavy Cap, I don't know what to tell you. I also hate Wavy Cap. But, okay. Got taken straight to Mom. Yep. I just want to get into... Just get me out of this run, please. Okay, that was Blood Oath, I think. We keep teleporting backwards randomly. And anyone and everyone who asks me all the time, Victor, you got to do a TM trainer run. This is why we don't. Right here. We can do it for fun for sure. Just not on not on this file. I just want to get taken to Isaac. We're recovering HP. I'm not sure how. Please stop taking us in the opposite direction of where I want to go. Please. I think we have Dr. Fetus. There's a soul heart in here that we can't pick up because we're at full HP. Things are dying and being turned into soul hearts randomly, so that's cool. I'm down with that. But one thing I'd be down with even more is getting out of this run. Oh my god. Kill him. Okay, he's dead. Thank. I'm trying, y'all. I'm trying to get out of here as fast as possible. Trust me. We don't have, we do not have mapping anymore. And we've gone the wrong way. Yeah, we are, something is just constantly giving us HP. I'm not sure what. I'm gonna go ahead and put the do not watch this video tag on here. If any of you made it by now or made it this far, congrats. This is a serious request. If anyone from the dev team is listening, which I know they probably don't, please give us an option to disable Wavy Cap. There's no reason for the game to do this. And the game crashed. Okay. I was trying to go back to the main menu to try to reset Wavy Cap to see if that would work, and the game crashed. Which means we have to start, I think, at the chest. TM Trainer. Okay, it did work. And hey, you get mad at me all you want for doing that. I'm saving us all the headache of having to deal with that. I really do implore. I implore Nicholas, please let us have some way of getting rid of the Wavy Cap effect or disabling it. It's funny for about maybe 2 seconds, and then after that, it actually gets obnoxious. And those of you like let the people who want to experience this all they want. Hey, let them keep the option on, but man. I think we've gone in an Isaac circle, maybe. I can't even tell anymore. Yeah, I see the boss room. That's all I'm looking at is the map at this point. Get me out of this, please. Thank God. Well, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed that. Yep. I'm just going to say, if you made it this far, give yourself a like and a thumbs up and a pat on the back. And I hope that your eyes weren't bleeding as much as some other people's were probably. And thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing. What a wacky way to kick off the weekend here. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Christopher Wright, Medic Wolf, McMannon, Flotz Callen Canceny, Bree B, and Tyler Sears. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Invicta.